Hey everybody, Michael Hand here. And on our last video, I got a lot of comments asking how I created my Van de Graaff generator. So I thought I would show you how it's all set up and how you can make one for super cheap. Let's do it. All right, starting from the bottom, I've got a nice little cutting board down here. And on the cutting board, I have my motor attached. This is just a refrigerator compressor motor. But the motor actually isn't super important. All that's important is that it spins, it can move your belt, and you can attach a roller to it. Attached to my motor is my bottom roller. This is actually a nylon just bed caster, and then I have it wrapped in a piece of pantyhose. I'll talk about the pantyhose more later, but this makes it so it's a neutral bottom roller, and then the pantyhose helps with gripping. All right, the bottom brush is actually super important, but people forget about it. I just have a copper piece with some desoldering braid attached to it. This is what's gonna be supplying the electrons from the earth. So this is very important. Make sure that it has good contact with the ground, otherwise you won't get a great charge. Next up is just the base of the generator. This is just a big old ABS pipe that has a couple of fittings on it, one to attach it to the board and one to make it so I can easily make fine adjustments to the bowls up here. All right, onto the sphere. These are actually two IKEA bowls just taped together with some electrical tape. These are really awesome because they have basically no lip whatsoever. One thing that you want to make sure of is that you don't have sharp edges on your sphere, otherwise you'll lose your charge to coronal discharge. All right, so in most cases, you would want to cut a hole out of your big old bowls and attach them to your pipe fitting. I did this a really long time ago and didn't feel like doing it with the new IKEA bowls, but you'd want to cut a hole in the IKEA bowls and put them on top of your fitting. All right, let's talk brushes. So I use some soldering braid that seems to work pretty well. Pretty much anything that has a whole lot of points that you can spread out works well. Some people use like copper mesh or brass mesh. Anything that has a whole lot of tiny points that will collect the charge over an area will work for you. And then you just attach those to your bowl. All right, onto the belt. This is what makes my design kind of special, I think. This is made out of just nylon pantyhose. Most people use rubber belts and then you use kind of different rollers to create the charge. This, what I'm doing is I have the nylon pantyhose and then my top roller actually is just a piece of PVC pipe that is staying stationary and the belt is just creating friction and rubbing on top. This I found is the most reliable way to create a charge. The only downside is that because you're using a cloth belt, it's more susceptible to humidity changes, but for the most part, this works extremely well and it's for like $2 in parts. All right, those are all the bits. Let's put it back together and see if it still works. All right, that's my generator build. As you can see, it's working pretty good. It needs some adjustments. Let me know if you guys want to build one because they are so much fun, trust me. Tryin, youtube.com/Tryin. Subscribe. Thanks.
Not quite as good as before, but.
Hi. Yep, that's good.